using parallel universes, graph theory, combinatorics, and sheer willpower, I was able to make the most advanced game in PowerPoint ever. Well, Google Slides. With over 1,000 individual slides, we have an open world maze game with lighting and puzzles and a dragon.
Hey, what's going on? I'm a dragon.
I mean, it's still a simple game, but come on, it's PowerPoint. So how was this all made? Let's find out. So it turns out games aren't like a slideshow where each action takes you to a different slide. I know, shocking, but I remember thinking that when I was 10 years old. So like, what if 10-year-old me never learned the truth? In a previous video, I showed one of my first games, which happened to be made in PowerPoint 18 years ago. It was an avoid the ball type of game inspired by Particles by Ragdoll Software. But yeah, in this video, I don't want to make yet another avoid the moving object type of game. These people made whole videos about that. No, I want to do something never done before and take decision tree logic to the extreme. Think about it. We can link any PowerPoint slide to any other with a button. Then we can connect one slide to two slides to create a branching structure. And what has a better branching structure than? That's right, a maze. The simplest maze is, well, one where you make no decisions. And when I was a kid, I made Deform Alex, which is basically a linear slideshow of pretty unsettling deformations of me as a stick figure made in Flash. We can definitely do way better than that, though. I mean, this isn't even a game, so let's show little old me what we could do now. All right, so I've created some game assets, and I'm ready to make the maze. We'll focus on the walls and the player for now, but I did make some other elements for when we're ready to do some advanced PowerPoint development. And there we go. I pasted the tiles into slides. From this starting position, the player can already make one of three choices, which means we'll need to duplicate the slide three times and route each of the arrow buttons to the correct ones. Then for each of the destination slides, we route the opposite buttons back to slide one. Now look, we can navigate one tile ahead. Now we just have to extend that for the whole maze. To visualize the branching structure we have ahead of us, we can use a tree. No, not that kind of tree. Stop it. It's a type of graph, perfect for visualizing each slide and its various connections. We'll put the player there at the start so we can keep track of where they are. And you know what? Just for you, I'll make it look like a tree. Now don't get confused by this. It's literally the exact same maze. By the way, you can visualize a chess game in the same way. Each valid chess move is another branch. But if we actually made chess in PowerPoint, it would take approximately this many slides. That's too many slides. But yeah, we'll keep updating this tree as we go. And there we go. We're up to 81 slides. And it works. It feels like an actual maze game already. But this is by far not complicated enough for me. So what happens when we add a locked door and a key? Well, now there are suddenly two universes. One where the hero has collected the key, and one where the hero has not. So they can no longer access half of the maze because the door is locked. The trick is pretty simple. When the hero collects the key, they basically travel from the one universe to the other, which just means we have to go to the slide with the key and route it to the second set of slides where the key is gone and the door is locked. Slide 101. Nice. Actually, I'm going to go one step further. So there's a universe where the key is here, one where it's in the hero's pocket, and a final one where the door is unlocked after you walk up to it. It's just more clear to the player to see the key in their inventory when they collect it, and to see it get used up when they open the door. It just means we have more slides, of course. And here's what our graph looks like now. Three universes. By the way, here's a really cool thing we could do with our state graphs now. Since you can only enter this universe where the key is when you collect it, we could make it look like the key is the start of the maze over here. Again, it doesn't change anything about the maze itself. We're just saying it starts at the key. Similarly, since you can only enter this last universe through the door by unlocking it, we can make the door the start of the maze over here. Now, we can combine all three universes into one monstrous tree. there's a couple tiles here that the hero technically can't access without already having collected the key. So we know these two slides aren't needed. And again, you can't go to the other side of the door unless it's open, so we can get rid of all these slides to clean things up quite a bit. Okay, so here we are with 181 slides. So let's collect the key. And now we've technically teleported to the key in the inventory universe. And then we'll go and unlock the door. And now we're in the opened door universe. Awesome, perfect. But 181 slides is nothing. Before we add more slides though, it's not much of a challenge if you can see everything at once. So I've prepared some variations of the walls so we can add lighting. All right, finally. I manually updated the walls for all 81 player locations, and I reapplied the door logic. But look how much nicer this looks. And now we're ready to make this a game by adding an objective. All right, we're gonna get real cheesy here, but you have to rescue the princess from the greedy dragon who is blocking your way. The way to get past it is to offer it 3 diamonds scattered throughout the maze. We'll start with the first diamond over here. The player can get the diamond before or after getting the key, so we just have to duplicate all of the slides all over again. Yep, the universe doubles once again. Half of the universes are now where the diamond is still here, and half of them are where the diamond is in the hero's pocket. So yeah, when the hero collects the diamond, they travel to this set of universes. There's a catch though. They can get the diamond before collecting the key, after collecting the key, or after the door is opened. Oh, and we can't forget, there are some tiles here that can't be reached without already having collected the diamond. Let's remove those. Oh, and the dragon is blocking the way up here, so we can mark these as inaccessible too. The next diamond is way up here. So since you can get diamonds in any order, we just have to do it all over again. Duplicate the universe, connect all 6 possible states, remove impossible to reach places, add the diamond to the inventory in half the universes, and done. All right, now the last diamond is interesting because the hero can only collect it after having opened the door, which means it's only these 4 routes that we have to duplicate. And only one of these 4 final universes does the hero have all 3 diamonds. It is here, on the single slide out of 964, that the dragon will let us pass. Speaking of which, once the dragon moves out of the way, we do need one final universe where it took your diamonds. That means this area is finally accessible, so you'll be able to walk up to the princess and reach the end. And can't forget, we need a title slide. Woo! Finally, we've done it. 1,046 slides and the world's most complicated PowerPoint game. Let's celebrate by playing the final game. All right, here we are in Google Slides. Let's give it a go. Let's play. So let's go straight up. Can't get through this door, so might as well start exploring, right? Oh yeah, a key. Let's keep going in this direction. We got our first diamond. All right, I see a key here. Let's go get that key. There's a diamond here. Let's get the diamond then because it's on the way. Here's the key. Let's go back to the door because we know where it is. And unlock it. Boom. Oh no, there's a dragon.
Hey, what's going on?
Let's see what it says. You want me to move? No way. Maybe for 3 diamonds though. I'm sorry, dragon. I don't have 3 diamonds. I love the lighting. It's such a great effect. It's so much better because of it. And here's the diamond! Okay, cool. We have 3 diamonds now. Let's take it back to the dragon. Alright, dragon. What do you say? Nice! 3 diamonds! Yummy! You may proceed. Perfect. Let's go. And there we are. There's a princess. Let's have a little chat. You want to save me? Maybe for 3 diamonds! Yup, that's a game. Alright, thanks so much for watching. If you like YouTubers and game developers, then subscribe and follow my secret Patreon. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!